In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which you can handle existing data to create new columns in the underlying data table. The generic term handle is used in the title of this learning module because some of the new columns will be created using mathematical calculations, while others may involve the organization of data based upon categorical attributes or even cherry-picking values based upon visual attributes. One of the more common ways to create new columns based upon existing data is to perform calculations. Spotfire's calculated column capability works best in one of two ways. First, performing calculations going across rows, and second, performing calculations going down the entire column. Let's take a look at an example of each type of calculation in a quick demonstration. Use Open File and locate the example with Data Handling Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. We can take a moment to evaluate this data table in its entirety. These columns of office supplies data were all imported from our external data source. If we proceed to the next tab, there are three examples of how the imported columns were used to generate new calculated columns. This table shows that a calculation was performed for values going across each row by taking the existing sales price and discount amounts and applying them within an expression which calculates the price without a discount applied. The resulting column was named list price. In the first row, you can see that 0% discount results in the same value for the sale price and the list price. However, in the second line, the sale price was discounted 10%. Therefore, the list price before the discount was applied is calculated accordingly. In the second table, an expression was applied which calculated the average of a single column. This expression instructed Spotfire to perform the calculation going down the column and generated the repeating value of 5% as the overall average discount. In the final table, we leveraged this calculated column to create yet another calculated column. This one shows the difference from average for each row. Negative values indicate that the applied discount is below average, and positive values indicate that the applied discount is above average. If we scroll down to the bottom of the filters, you can see that each of our calculated columns has resulted in a new filter. Another way to generate new columns of data based upon existing data is to bin values. Here you can see a data column which represents the age of each customer in years and a bar chart which counts the number of customers at each age. Inserting a binned column would allow you to represent that same data visually in a way which is much easier to interpret. The binned column tool affords several different options for taking a continuous column of data and dividing it into categorical bins. Let's take a look at a few of these examples as we continue our demonstration. On the tab titled Binned Columns, you can see the profit column from the originally imported data columns and a histogram which relates the distribution of those 7,090 different profit values. The Binned Column tool has already been applied to the profit column three different times in order to generate these three columns of data and the corresponding filters. The first example binned the profit data into five bins by even intervals, meaning that the four equidistant values between the lowest value and the highest value define the limits of each of the five bins. As we mouse over each bar, you can see that the individual profit values which were grouped between each of those limits are highlighted. As you can see, this approach often results in odd data ranges or limits. If we wanted to customize those limits, we could bin by specific limits. This column relates the results of setting specific limits for binning profit values at 250, 500, and 1250. As we mouse over each bar, you can see how this approach grouped profit values. A third option for defining bins is to calculate the variability or spread of the data expressed as a standard deviation. This column displays the results of binning by standard deviation. The sigma symbol represents a standard deviation unit away from the mean, so we can mouse over the profit values which were below the mean, and those which were an increasing number of standard deviation units above the mean in order to see them related to the individual profit values. While each of these approaches uses numerically defined limits to take continuous data and group it into categories, Tags are another option for generating new categorical data columns. With tags, you can cherry-pick data using marking so that it can be defined as a group. You might even consider this a mechanism to save a marking because the marked values are annotated with tag names. When you create a tag collection, it creates a new column in the underlying data table. The names of the tags within that collection are the values in the new column. So, as you actively attach each tag to the current marked data set of interest and repeat, you are essentially building a new column of data with the appropriate values, which you might consider to be custom labels, annotation, or simply a new categorical group assignment. Let's take a quick look at some tags which have already been configured in our demonstration example. On the page titled Tags and Lists, you can see that the Tags panel is displayed along the left side of the visualization space. The first tag collection was created to capture outliers. It has only one tag, titled Yes. If we scroll to the bottom of the filters, you can see the associated outliers column, which has two values, Yes and Untagged. This column has been applied as a color by variable on the scatter plot, such that those values which were marked and tagged as outliers can clearly be seen. If we wanted to add additional data to this tag, which we consider to be outliers, we could mark that data, select the Yes tag, and click the icon to attach the Yes tag to the marked rows. You can see the red color has been applied, and when we click where there are no markers, that color remains, due to the change of those values in the outliers column. A second tag collection has been created in this example. The scenario here is that our imported data table had 5 levels of order priority. We wanted to simplify the data by creating only 3 levels of order priority. So this bar chart was used to mark the old order priority assignments and group them to create these new order priority assignments. The resulting tag column has already been added as a color by property, and we could drag and drop the column in order to make our new order priority the category axis value on this bar chart. Another option for capturing marked values is the Lists tool. You could save lists of customers, contracts, oil wells, patients, regions, sales orders, employees, account numbers, heck, any single column of data from your analysis using the Lists tool. Much like tags, lists are created by association with data you have marked. However, unlike tags, lists are stored separately from the analysis document. This is useful because it allows you to extract data of interest and relate that information across different Spotfire analysis sessions. Let's return to our demonstration and consider the following scenario. Our data table contains 76 sales associates. Our human resources department also uses Spotfire to analyze employee data. Consequently, we have asked them to bin sales associates based upon years of experience and send us a list file. They happily complied. In order to open that file, we need to visit the View menu and launch the Lists panel. In the resulting panel, we will use this drop-down menu to import lists. Then navigate to the location of the Lists file with List from HR in the title. Click Open. And we can click the plus symbol in order to expand the view of lists, which indicate different ranges of years of experience. If we click on a list, you can see that each list contains our sales associates' names. Therefore, we need to change this selector to sales associate. We can now apply the lists in one of two ways. We could right-click on any list in order to mark the items, based upon the names of associates in that list. Or, if we select all 4 lists, we could use the drop-down menu to create a tag collection. The new tag collection appears in the Tags panel, and as you know, a tag collection is always associated with a column in the underlying data table. So we could take this new column and drag and drop it on the trellis target of the scatter plot, just as one example of how that new data column could be leveraged. Another option which is available to provide new elements for your analysis is to insert a hierarchy. Date and time data tend to lend themselves quite readily to hierarchical organization from the information related in a single column. However, other categorical data types represented in separate data columns can also be organized into hierarchies. The best way to appreciate this capability is to return one more time to our example demonstration. On the tab titled Hierarchies, two bar charts have been configured to count the number of orders. And in this bar chart, although date columns do have pre-configured hierarchies presented within visualization selectors, the hierarchy we wanted, year, month, week, is not among the options presented. Therefore, a custom date hierarchy was created and applied to the category axis of this bar chart. We can use this slider in order to view the monthly order counts and then weekly order counts. In order to explain this bar chart, you should know that we have an imported column in the underlying data table which defines our products, numbering just over 1,000, and imported columns which group those products into three primary categories, 17 secondary categories, and 60 tertiary categories. It is these four categorical columns which were utilized to build another custom hierarchy. That hierarchy has been applied to the category axis of this bar chart, and sliding the hierarchy slider allows us to examine the order count at each level of categorical organization. While these custom hierarchies are not technically columns, they are appended to the underlying data table, they do present filters, and if we visit the Edit menu to launch the Column Properties dialog, as we scroll to the bottom of the list of columns which are labeled with the imported column type, we eventually reach the calculated, binned tags, and hierarchy elements which have resulted from our handling of those imported columns in Spotfire.